tell me a little bit about what you do after you get off your horse in cross country. From then until the next morning, you're jogged. Make sure that he's in the best shape possible.
Yeah, well, after you've cooled them out in the box and they come back to the barns, you check all their legs, make sure there's no cuts or anything. You jog them up, see how they're feeling. You immediately get mine and ice front and hind legs all the way from the foot up to the knee, and hind legs from the hock down. Stand in muck tubs or whirlpool boots. You want to leave that on for about 20 minutes or so. Take it off for an hour, and you can put it back on. I prefer to keep my horses out moving a lot. You know, if you think about running a very long distance that you're not normally used to running, and then you sit, you're going to be much more sore if you've sat and then get back up. So you try and keep them moving and walking and grazing as much as possible. You do fluids. A lot of people do IV fluids to replenish all of the water that they've lost and rehydrate them for Sunday morning. Some don't do that. It's just an extra help for some horses that don't drink as well. And then that next morning, when you're preparing for the jog up, they have to be braided and look beautiful, but also make sure they're feeling good. So most people actually take their horse out for a ride in the morning, not to train on them as much as just loosen them up. Another round of icing, take a look at their shoes, make sure everything looks good. A lot of people pack their feet at night. And yeah, and I mean, if the way to make sure you have a sound and healthy horse to the best of your ability is to have done your conditioning and your training for months and years, really, but to make sure you have a really good plan up to that event so you don't end up overtaxing their body that day.